Hello students, I hope all of you are well. In previous lecture, I tell you about the applications of trigonometry, that is a height and distance. So I hope all of you know better now how you can solve the daily life problems by using trigonometry. So now to continue this topic, I am going more examples to solve daily life examples. Okay, now I am taking one of your question number 9. It is the angle of elevation of top of the building from the foot of the tower is 30 degree, and the angle of the elevation of the top of the tower from the foot of the building is 60 degree. If the tower is 50 meter high, find the height of the building. So this kind of questions students make a confusion. Then I am making a first figure to show you how the students make a confusion. How you can deduct your confusion. So there are two objects are given. One is a building and the second one is a tower. It is very clear that one is in a small size and the other one is in a big size. So clear, this angle is smaller and this angle is larger. Now you can solve this. Look at here, the angle of elevation top of the building from the foot of the tower is 30 degree. Top of the building, foot of the tower, 30 degree. Top of the building, so that means this is a building. And then the next one is the angle of elevation top of the tower to the top of the tower, so that means this is a tower, is 60 degree. Okay, if the tower is 50 meter high, so it's very clear that it is 50 meter. This is how you can draw the figure without making any confusion. Now label it. These are the right angles. Okay. Now what is given here? It is the height of the tower. So I am taking this triangle CBD. Why I am taking CBD? Because the length, one height is given, so you can find here BD. This BD is a common length between these two triangles, ABD and CBD. So when you calculate BD, from BD you can find here AB. So I am taking in triangle CBD, this is 90 degree. This angle CBD is 60 degree and this height is given CD 50 meter. Okay, so BD, it is the base over perpendicular. Base over perpendicular is called 60 degree. BD is equal to 50 over under root meter. Okay, then this is your equation 1. In triangle ABD, this angle ABD is 90 degree. Angle ADB is 30 degree. And BD is 50 over under root 3 meter. So this AB upon BD is equal to tan 30 degree. AB is equal to 50 upon 3, 50 upon under root 3, sorry, into tan 30 degrees 1 over under root 3. So this becomes 50 over 3 meter. So you can write like this, or you can make it simple. You can write. Then you write the result. Therefore, height of building is 16 and 2 over 3. Height of building is 16 and 2 over 3 meter. Okay, I am taking one of your question, question number 11. Already figure is given here. A TV tower stands vertically on a bank of canal. From the point on the other bank directly opposite to the tower, the angle of elevation top of the tower is 60 degree. From another point 20 meter away from the point on the line joining this point to the foot of the tower, the angle of elevation of the top of the tower is 30 degree. Find the height of the tower and the width of the canal. So this figure is given already. So you can draw a figure here. I am taking this figure. A, B, this point is C. B, this length is given 20 meter, and 30 degree and 60 degree angles. Okay, first I am taking here in triangle ABC, angle ABC is 90 degree. Angle ACB is 60 degree. Then AB upon BC, it is perpendicular over base, is tan 60 degree. AB is equal to BC under root 3. This is your equation number 1. Then in triangle ABD, angle ABD is 90 degree and angle ADB is 30 degree. Now here AB upon BD is equal to tan 30 degree. AB is equal to BD upon under root 3. This is your equation number 2. Now look at equation 1 and 2 here. In both equations, left hand side, that means the AB side, is common. So from equation 1 and 2, BC under root 3 is equal to BD under root 3. Sorry, BD upon under root 3. So now you can solve it. This becomes ABC is equal to BD. 3BC, BD can be written as BC plus CD. So it is 2BC is equal to CD. CD is given 20. CD is given 20 meter. So BC can be written as 10 meter. So it is very clear that BC, it is the width of the river. BC is the width of the river. So the question is find the height of the tower and the width of the canal. So we write here, therefore, width of canal is equal to 10 meter. Now we have to find here the height. So you can put here the value in any of the equation. I am taking here, put this value in equation 1. Equation 1. So you got here AB is equal to BC under root 3. So you can put here the value also 70.32. Therefore, height of tower is equal to 70.32. So we get both answers here. Similarly, you can solve the other questions. I am taking your question number 15 here of your exercise. So your question number 15 here, a straight highway leads to the foot of the tower. A man standing at the top of the tower observes a car of angle of depression 30 degree which is approaching the foot of the tower with a uniform speed. 6 seconds later, the angle of depression of the car is found to be 60 degree. Find the time taken by the car to reach the foot of the tower from the point. Okay. This is, I am showing here the tower. From the top of the tower, a car approaching to the foot of the tower, the angle of elevation is 30 degree. After 6 seconds, car approaches to this point and the angle of elevation become, so this is 6 seconds. The time is given here after 6 seconds. This car moves to point C and the angle of elevation become 60 degree. And the time taken to cover the distance CD is 6 seconds. We have to find the time taken to approach from C to B. So I am taking in triangle ABC. Angle B is 90 degree. Angle ACB is 60 degree. So AB upon BC is equal to tan 60 degree. AB is equal to BC under root. This is your question number 1. In triangle ABD, now I am taking the full triangle ABD. ABC is 90, ABD is 90 degree, and this angle ADB is 30 degree. AB upon BD is equal to tan 30 degree. AB is equal to BD upon root 3. Look at the equation 1 and 2, the left hand side AB is common. So from equation 1 and 2, BC under root 3 is equal to BD over So it is 3BC is equal to BD. Same way in previous question done. Put here BD as BC plus CD. So 2BC is equal to CD. So BC is equal to CD upon. So what is the relation between now these two? BC and CD. BC is half of distance CD. So it is very clear that the time taken by this car, because the speed is uniform, so the time taken will be the half the time taken by the cover distance CD. It is 3 seconds. So time taken by car to cover distance BC is the half time taken to cover distance CD, that is 3 seconds. Okay students, there is one more question of your exercise, the last one. The angle of elevation of the top of the tower from two points at a distance of 4 meter and a 9 meter from the base of the tower and the same straight line with it are complementary. All of you know the complementary angles. Those two angles have a sum 90 degree are known as complementary angles. Prove that the height of the tower is 6 meter. So this question is actually is at a distance of 4 meter and the other is at a distance of 9 meter. And these two angles are complementary. So if one angle is theta, then the other will be 90 degree minus theta. So I am taking here BC on BC BC 4 meters. Okay. So here BC is given 4 meter and BD is given 9 meter. Angle, let angle ACB be theta, then angle ADB is equal to 90 degree minus theta. Okay. Now in triangle ABC, this AB upon BC is equal to tan theta. AB is equal to BC, BCD is 4, 4 tan theta. This is equation number 1. In triangle ABD, angle ABD is 90 degree and this BD is 9 meter. So AB upon BD is equal to tan 90 degree minus theta. So can also be written as cot theta, because tan 90 degree minus theta is equal to cot theta.
this you already studied in previous chapter, chapter 8. So AB is equal to 9 cot theta. This is your question number 2. Now simply multiply equation 1 and 2. AB square is equal to 4 into 9 into 10 theta into cot theta. So it is 36. 10 theta, cot theta can be also written as 1 over 10 theta. AB square is equal to 36, AB is equal to 6. So therefore, height of tower is equal to 6 meter is proved. So this we can solve by using trigonometry, the daily life problems. So there are some more problems are here. We discuss later, but now you have to complete your exercise 9.1 of your NCERT, and I hope all of you understand what is the relation between height and distance by using these type questions. Okay, students, bye.